Hello guys, welcome back to BBE, Bina Brain Ke Engineer. So this is the part 4 video for the RBI chapter under Banking Awareness series. And today's topic is Monetary Policy and its Committee. So let's start. Let's revise about the topics already has been covered. The part 1 video contained the top central banks. The top central banks consist of US Federal Reserve. If you remember, it is the world's largest federal reserve, consisting 25% of the world economy. Then European Central Bank, People's Bank of China. Then RBI is world's sixth largest bank. So all these things. Then history and organizational structure. RBI was constituted in 1935, nationalized in 49. Organizational structure, like there is governor on the top, then deputy governor, then executive directors, then principal chief managers. So there are 12 executive directors, 4 deputy governors. In 12, the current newest one is Sudha Balakrishnan. As on the video is made on 2018 June, so it could change everything. So then there are department and offices of RBI. As on June 2018, there were 34 departments and 31 regional plus sub offices of RBI across the India. See, these all data are volatile, but the important thing is you should know what are the department and what are the important departments of the RBI. So today we are going to discuss here is monetary policy, and its instrument will be covered in the next section, because you need to understand what is monetary policy and what's its importance. So I would keep it to that thing. It is all today, everything is not about facts, it's much more about understanding what is monetary policy. So let's start. It refers to the policy of central bank to use monetary instrument. Policy, for this policy, which instruments are going to use to achieve its target or goal. So RBI has some target and goal, and that main target and goal is primary objective. That is the main target, to maintain the price stability. See, this is the most important role of the function of RBI, to maintain price stability while keeping in the mind objective of growth. See, who is going to do the growth? That is the purpose of government. So whenever government is going to do the growth, RBI has to maintain the price stability. And I will give you the complete example that how the growth is going to make price instable. That how money is going to instable whenever the government is going for the growth. Now, other objective, which are secondary objective of the monetary policy, which it has also worked out, that adequate flow of credit to the productive sectors like the agriculture. It should get the money which is required. Then IT sector, which are very important for Indian economy, because we are going to export only IT products, okay, service sector. So these are the important, adequate flow of credit, money. Credit means cash or money. Money is going to that sector. Maintain economic and financial stability. Now this is very important thing. See, economic stability or financial stability goes up and down when there is large amount of money is sucked or money is invested into the market, then there is instability, financial instability. Or economic instability is when there is large cause of disaster or anything which is not expected from the government. Like, let me give you an example of the financial instability now. See how it could be caused. If you see the crude oil prices, I am talking about in the June 2018, scenario could be different. At the moment, the crude oil prices are $80 per barrel, okay. And this is what we are expecting, the government and RBI was expecting $80 per barrel in the international market. Due to some reason, US decided that they are going to import large amount of crude oil they need for a plant or something. They decided that they are not going to produce crude oil themselves. US has their own oil reserve and they also import from the Gulf countries. Now US decided that they are not going to produce oil for themselves at the moment, and they will use it later for in the future purpose. So what they are going to do, they are going to import crude oil from the Gulf countries. Now what this is, demand pull in inflation. So demand has increased. Now the Gulf countries, which is selling $80 per barrel, what they will do, they will make increase the price, and price may go up to $120 per barrel. Now this is what not expected from the government of India. Now what would happen if the price has increased by 50%? It would lead to what? Now government, the India import such a large amount of crude oil, Okay, there is crude oil import bill around 300-400 billion US dollar for India at the moment. So what would happen? It would also increase by 50% because we need oil and petrol and diesel is our basic necessity. We need it for the functioning of our economy. So we have to buy the oil, and what that would cause such a large amount of money going unexpectedly from the RBI without even preparation, then it would cause financial instability. And that is the purpose of the Monetary Policy Committee will come into the role, and it will try to stabilize this whatever you can call instability. Now, how economic instability is hampered? Let me give you the example. See, take about agriculture sector. Okay, the monsoon is coming around, and let's just say that monsoon causes flood in the 2-3 states, and mostly those states like Bihar, West Bengal, okay, and UP. These states are what your agricultural base states. So if there is such a large amount of flood in this section, it means agriculture sector, we are expecting, as on June 2018, we are expecting good monsoon and a good agricultural produce for this year. But monsoon might go up without our expectation, or any natural disaster occurred and agricultural produce is reduced. Okay. So what is this? Then this is economic instability, because if agricultural prices are going to low, what would happen? Government has to look out against the farmer. They will provide, if flood destroys or natural disaster destroys their produce, what would they do? They would give insurance. Farm insurance would be given to the farmers. They have crop insurance. Then farmer will be given loan waivers off. Then they might get additional some amount of money from the government. So government, which wasn't expecting all this, has to pay extra to the what? To the farmers. If you see example, like government is paying such a lot, 2 lakh, more than 2 lakh to the banking sector, but that was expected. Banks are going into the negative sector, they are incurring losses, that was expected already. Now thing is, it was already known to the bank, to the government, so that is not going to cause that much economic instability. That is going to cause only loss. But the monsoon failure would cause instability because government was not prepared to spend such a large amount of money in there. I hope this is clear to you, adequate of flow. This is also now promotion of productive investment and trade. See, for development you need investment and you need trade. Okay, if there is no investment, see, if I am having a person, I am working over a salary, I am a salaried person, I am working, I am using my saving, I am saving money. If I am just keeping it with myself in my home, then this is money, is stalled money. It is useless money because it cannot be used in the growth. So we should promotion of productive investment. People should invest. Like if you are sending your money into the bank for the saving account, then you are also investing, but investing in the bank for the 3.5 rate of interest. So people should be promotion should be done for the investment. If investment can, then only the development can go. Now monetary authority has some instrument. Like I told you, then if prices goes by $80 to $120, then what will RBI do? I would be explaining you in the upcoming section. So all this power has been vested into the RBI through the RBI Act 1934. Okay. And after the nationalization, RBI become the monetary authority for the Indian economy. So now for the monetary policy and its relation with the development, I told you. Now let me explain you what is fiscal deficit. It is also called Vittiya Ghata in Hindi. So it is the total expenditure of the government in a year and total revenue generated by the government in that same year. See, now I will give you a little bit of example how this works. What is the expenditure of the government? It's very easy. Expenditure of the government is like for the development purpose, like creating hospitals, then giving schemes to the farmers, health scheme, then whatever salary to their employees. All this is the expenditure of the government, making infrastructure, government hospital, everything is this. So what is the revenue? Now revenue is generated by two ways. There are direct taxes which is deducted from the salary of the person, and there are indirect taxes. This is the main portion of the source of the income. Direct taxes, only 1% of the people of India are paying direct taxes, so it is not that much. Now, indirect tax is paid by everyone. Indirect taxes is how? See, if you go to a restaurant, you are paying 5% GST. So if you buy anything of 1000 rupees, if your bill is of 1000 rupees in a restaurant, the 50 rupees is directly going to the government. Now, if you buy any electrical good, like you say mobile, okay, or you can say iron, whatever you buy, so all geyser, whatever AC, so these are charged in 18% GST slab. So if you are buying an AC of 20,000, then 3600 rupees, 18%, 18 to the 36. So 3600 rupees is going to whom? It is directly going into the government, which we people don't usually ignore. So these are the indirect taxes, which are the main source of the revenue of the government. Now see, we also have a monthly source of income, and in some month we might spend more than our salary. Like, just assume that government has 1 lakh crore rupees as the revenue. It is an example. Revenue is much more higher than this, and government made expenditure little bit higher than this. Like, let us assume 110,000 crore rupees. Now, if government has expenditure can go on a high, even for a common people, you can spend more money in a month or in a year than the salary. So this happens usually. Government is always spending more than its revenue generated. So what the fiscal deficit here is 10,000, because it is the extra money. But the fiscal deficit is usually coined in the percentage. Yani ki 10,000 of the 1 lakh crore would become as 10%. So what is the fiscal deficit for my example? The fiscal deficit for my example was 10%. Now I hope you have cleared what is the fiscal deficit. And remember, government always has a higher expenditure than the revenue generated. So from where government get this extra money? It has already taken out the money from the taxes. It can increase the taxes, but it will take time to bring the money. Now they require money because they are going to expend it. So what they do? They do borrowings. Now what is borrowing? I will explain you in the money monetary policy instrument how these borrowings comes. That it took, for the moment understand that it take money from the market. Like I told you, people like me and everyone is having money, and government has already deducted taxes from me, but it still need money. It would give me interest and take money from us. So it will pick money from the market by offering extra interest to them. Okay, I hope it is clear for the moment. Now, what was the fiscal deficit for 2016-17? It was 3.51%. For the last financial year, it was again 3.5%. Target was 3.2, but we was not able to reach it because we go through the demonetization and implementation of GST. So both these things led to the extra expenditure of the government, actually lesser revenue generated. So revenue was less generated, and that why fiscal deficit went higher against the target. For 18-19, the target is 3.3%. These are revised on every year. Like, there is also the target which is set 3.2 for 19-20, but it could be revised next year. So at the moment, for the financial year 18-19, we have target 3.3%. See, if the crude oil prices increases, government's expenditure is going to increase, and fiscal deficit is directly going to increase. So always remember, if the crude oil prices increases, fiscal deficit is increasing. You might be reading news that government is not removing its central excise duty. If government removes its central excise duty, then it has to face money. If it has to lose its money, it is gonna lose its revenue, and fiscal deficit is gonna increase. Whereas government has set the target 3.3% and it wants to reach it. So now there is another term, inflation. Inflation is the rate at which the general level of prices for goods and services is rising. Consequently, the purchasing power of currency is falling. So let me explain you how the inflation works. Now, I'm giving you a live example. Just check out what was the price of the land in your area 10 years before. Let us just say it was 1 lakh rupees. Okay. If you would have bought a money which was bought a piece of a land which was giving, who was priced on rupees 1 lakh. Now, if you ask me, I'm talking about 10 years back, like 2008, if you would have a land of peace which was cost you 1 lakh rupees. Now, what could be the price of the land in 2018? In 99% of the cases, the price of the land would have increased and it would have gone up to anywhere around 1,50,000. It could vary to the place to place. If the place is on the growing trend, if you are living in a small city and which is growing fast like Bhubaneswar or like you can say Ranchi of the Jharkhand, then the price increase would have shooted quite high. If you are living in a village area, then it has increased, but not that high. It would be increasing a little bit. If you are living in a place where people are migrating in, like a small, very small village of a Bihar, where youth is migrating to the Patna and another cities for the job, then what could have, even the price of land would have fallen. But in overall general case, the price of land would have increased. So what happened? Now you, for the same land, you was paying 1 lakh rupees in 2008 and in 2018 you have to pay 1.5 lakh. So what this is? For the same land, it means with the time the purchasing power of currency is reducing, because with 1 lakh you could, with 1 lakh with land which you could buy in 2008, you cannot buy in 18. That is mean purchasing power of the currency is falling. Or another thing is inflation. This is inflation, that slowly the price of every good, every service is increasing. That is inflation. Now, how inflation is of two type, how inflation is then, that one thing is demand push, okay, and another is cost push. Now, demand push is like, say the demand increases, like say India can produce only 2 lakh bikes annually, okay, that is our capacity, but suddenly the demand for the bike has increased, 2,50,000 people are more buying, trying to buy the bike. Then what would happen? If demand is increasing whereas production is the same, then automatically the price of the thing would increase. So this is the demand push inflation. Then there is cost push inflation. Let's just say that bike's raw material, which was like steel, aluminium, engine, that cost has increased. Then what would happen? If your cost, production cost is increasing, to make the profit you are going to increase the price of the produce. So that is also the production based or cost push inflation. Okay, so these are the two types of inflation. Now there is third kind of inflation, which is not any termed in a name, remember, which is the general inflation, that how the price of the land increased from 1 lakh to the 1.5 lakh. That is because of the money which is coming into the market. See, now the relation is coming into the role play. See, remember, government needs to do the development of the people. Okay, that is the main purpose of the government. What it wants to do? It wants to develop the people. Now, if it wants to do the development, if there is a poor person and it wants to develop him, then what he will do? The government will do what? Government will provide him some facilities via money. It roughly, if it provides it the person money, it is now not poor, it is now a rich person, or it has got some little bit of development. So money is the main source for the development, and government is going to provide money to into the market for the development of any sector or any people. See, that is the thing, that at the moment government is so much focused on the farmer that it is providing crop insurance schemes, then it is giving loan waivers of that, is it is providing money them to them so that they can get out of that poverty. So let me give you explanation that how sending money into the market, money to the market, is gonna cause inflation. Now understand, if you could, it would be an hypothetical example which is I'm gonna give you, so just try to remember it if you can, and if there is any problem I will try to explain it to you. Now see, if just let's take an example, there is a village, okay, and there are three people living in the village. The village is full of the poor people, no one has money with them, and there are poor people. Now government wants to do what? government wants to do the development of these people. Okay, now government can what do? They can invest the money. This is a hypothetical example. I am taking whatever I want to take. So I just say that government gives rupees 1 crore each in the village, okay, to every one person who's living in the village, it is giving rupees 1 crore, okay. Now, I told you that whenever there is induction of the money, there is gonna inflation. Now, let's just say that there were three parties in my village. Those three parties were, this is the shop seller, okay, this is the farmer, and this is the labor. There are three entities in the my government section. Now each, everybody has gotten rupees 1 crore rupees. Now this shopkeeper which used to sell milk at 40 rupees with 2 rupees margin, okay, he got to get milk for 40 rupees and he used to sell it at the price of 42 rupees. Because his income was merely 5,000, 10,000, the rupees 2 was good enough margin for him to make his salary 10,000. Now, what happens when he has got such a large amount of money? He say, I am a crorepati. Why should I do such a hard work for just 10,000 rupees which I was earning before? So, what he will say, okay, if I lost this 10,000 rupees, it's not going to hurt me that much. If I have to work out, he would say, I am going to sell this same milk which I was selling from buying it at 40 and selling it at 42, I am going to sell that milk at rupees 100 because I am a crorepati and I need money to satisfy need. I am not going to work for just rupees 2, I am a crorepati. So what he did, he directly picked up the price, made his margin rupees 60. Now the farmer which might need milk, okay, let's just say, change the example from milk to the anything else. Now farmer, let's just say this, need this milk very much important, okay, or just make it as a fertilizer. Now farmer just say, need this much very important, it's very important. Now farmer has also become a 1 crore rupees pati. Before that, if it has price has increased rupees 100, he cannot buy. But now he also have rupees 1 crore. Now what he would say, okay man, I am also a crorepati, who give a damn to rupees 40 or 100, I am such a rich person. He say, okay, I am going to buy the milk from you for the rupees 100. Now the person also bought the same thing. Now farmer needs laborer for the work. Now let's just say that labor was working rupees 100 per on the daily basis. Now labor says, I am a crorepati, I am not even also going to work for just rupees 10, like the same, he's not going to work for the rupees 2 profit. He would ask farmer, I am only going to work if you pay me 1,000 per day. Now farmer would say, okay man, I am also having quite a good money with me. Theek hai, I will pay you rupees 1,000. So what this happened? If you see the price of the commodities, like daily wager worker who was working on 1,000 is now working for the 1,000 rupees. The milk which was rupees 42 has shooted to the rupees 100 within instantaneously, because I made a situation, in hypothetical situation, that rupees 1 crore was given simultaneously to the people. So this is the example of 10 time prices increases. This is 10 time prices of inflation, which is not possible in current scenario. But whenever government give money into the villages, the inflation occur. I hope you have cleared how inflation occurred here. See, this, nothing has changed. No demand change, no production change. Both not, this is was not example of cost push, not even demand push. Both was same, still the inflation was there. From 42 it went to the 100 rupees. So this is the inflation which I was talking about, that whenever money is induced in the market, there is gonna be the what? There is gonna be the inflation. So coming back to the inflation, see, this inflation which I was talking about, that whenever government induces the money, the inflation occurs. Now the purpose of the monetary policy is sole purpose for the monetary policy. I told you these much objectives, that this is objective, that is objective. The main objective is the price stability, and for price stability you just need to work on the inflation. If you can curb inflation, the price stability is there, everything is very okay with it. So I hope this is clear to you. Now inflation, I will come up to this exemplary inflation. How now inflation for the little may give you details, like inflation in actual scenario for April 2018 was 4.37%, like if, and for May it was 4.87%, 6.7 or 4, okay. So these were the values for the inflation. This is the actual inflation. Okay, the inflation is not like 10 times large, it is the annual inflation. Or usually now there are different types of inflation, deflation. The example when I give you that price of the land decreases from 1 lakh, it comes to the 96,000. So this is the deflation. It means when the price is, the purchasing power of currency is increasing. Okay, then there is disinflation, when the rate of inflation is rising. Like just say, what example, in April in inflation was 4.3%, in May it comes to 4.1%, then it goes to 3.9%, then it goes to 2.1%. that is disinflation. And there is stagflation. Stagflation is when the inflation is very high, 30%, 20%, then these are the stagflation. And the example which I gave you, it was the example of hyperinflation. Even not even hyperinflation is of 100%, 50%. This is hyperinflation, which I gave you, that was of 1000% inflation. That is not even possible in actual scenario, but it can go up to 150%. That is hyperinflation. So moving on, now monetary policy, I told you, has to only control inflation. ठीक है, because government is going to induce money into the market for the development, and monetary policy has to drop this inflation. If inflation is very high, see, whenever government is going to do development, it is some going to do a subsequent sector. Like, let's just say, farmers got the money from the government for the development, but peasant doesn't got. And if farmer gets the money, inflation is going to happen. So farmer has got the money, they can cope up with the inflation. What about the peasant? They haven't got anything from the government. So they were saving rupees 1 lakh, okay, those peasant, and inflation is going on with the 10% rate. So what is going to happen, that whatever they are saving, that is kind of a useless, because they are, that is all is eaten up by the inflation. But government, so I hope it is clear. So whenever government go for a single sector, whereas inflation hit everybody. So then comes the RBI, that inflation should not go high because government is focused on some sector. What about other remaining people? Then government, then the monetary policy has to look out the inflation. Now monetary policy for the 5 years. See, monetary policy committee was made, and that monetary policy committee has given a target that you have to keep the inflation for the 5 period of time from 2016 to 21. So for this 5 year monetary policy committee was made, and they have been given the target of 4 ± 2%, yani ki from 6 to 2, only in this range you can keep the inflation. This is the range for which monetary policy has to keep the inflation in between. So, and what kind of inflation this is? This is the consumer price index. That it means the price which is increasing for same good, the price increase within a period of time is called consumer price index. And for that CPI, it has to be kept between 6% to 2%. That is the target for the monetary policy committee for the next 5 period up to 21. Okay. So consumer price index, the price which has increased for the consumer. There is wholesale price index, also WPI you might be. Then the wholesale price index is that what is the increase by the manufacturer. If manufacturer was selling something for rupees 100, okay, and consumer was getting it is for 200 rupees, and now let's just say that wholesaler is selling it at as 102 and consumer is getting it at 210. So what is the wholesale price index, or you can say what is the increase in the wholesale inflation? That is 2%. But what is for the consumer price index? 10% over 200 means 5% increase. So this is the consumer price index, this is the wholesale price index. I hope it is clear to you. Now moving on, this is the chapter, I told you that growth and inflation goes in hand with fiscal deficit. So this is the example from 15-16 to the current basis, and this is the expected range, this is the current scenario. So see, let me show you, during this range your inflation is stable, okay, around 4%. See, what was your GDP growth? It was also stable. So it was also stable. See, now when you see when there was drop in the inflation, it means the, there was, this is the scenario of disinflation. It is okay when there is a drop of the inflation, there was also drop in the growth. So if there is no in growth, it means inflation is dependent upon the growth. If there is no growth, it means no new money in the market. And if no new money in the market, it means what is going to happen? If no new money in the market, then there would be no inflation. I hope it is clear to you. Now, moving on to the next thing. Now comes the Monetary Policy Committee and how it curbs the inflation. Okay, so moving on, now let me go back how monetary policy. See, monetary policy has its instrument. Monetary policy, this is the last important thing and then I'm gonna finish the lecture. See, monetary policy, what it do? Let's just say, I will start from here. See, government has given so much of money into the market. This is my market. Government induced a large amount of money into the market. Now, what would happen? Inflation would increase. Okay. Automatically, if money is in the coming, inflation is going to increase. Now, RBI with its monetary policy can do what? It can suck out the money. ठीक है? Like if farmer got money from the government, he is going to take that money into the bank. Okay. And RBI can do what? RBI can suck that money through the monetary policy instruments. Suck that money through the monetary policy instrument. ठीक है? Into from the government. Let's just say that government is not able to provide money in the market. Government is not issuing money in the market. There is cash crunch in the market. Then what can monetary policy do with its instrument? It can directly induce the money into the market. If there is shortage of the money, then it can induce the money. It can also suck out the money. Government can also induce and suck out the money. Monetary policy is independent from the government. It will see market scenario. It will see the inflation. If they see that inflation is increasing because government induced the money, they will suck out the money through its instruments. Okay. Now I will explain you how it does with its different instruments. Like there is benchmark interest rate, everything is there. It was constituted for the first time, those are SOLA, for the 5 year, and it fixing the benchmark interest rate. Repo and reverse repo are the main rate which is going to held your inflation, always remember it. Then this committee, which is all deciding that how, when to induce money into the market or when to suck out the money, this is a 6-member committee. Okay, and this committee has to sit regularly to check out what is the market condition. They were requested or they were set at least to sit quarterly basis. It means they have to sit 4 times in a year, but they are more, you can say, active, and they are meeting on the bi-monthly basis. It means they meet on every 2 months. So they meet from the starting of the financial year in April, then subsequently in June, August, and August, leaving 1 month, October, December, February. So they meet 6 times in a year on the bi-monthly basis and decide whatever they need. So if you watch out the daily news, you can see RBI kept repo and reverse repo same in their bi-monthly meet. If you are watching this news in June 6th, 2018, RBI Monetary Policy Committee meet and they increase the repo rate and reverse repo rate by 0.25%. So all those things are done, and what would be the effect? That would be taught you in the next video, Monetary Policy Instrument. Now, all these member has to give the vote that repo rate was increased from 6% to 6.25%. So everyone has to vote for it. Should we increase or should we not increase? So every individual is going to vote out of this 6 member. If four or more vote goes to the single decision, that decision has been taken. If there is draw on the votes, it means 3 and 3 from both the sides. Then what is going to, whatever the RBI governor decide, RBI governor has the last vote. Now, the target for the Monetary Policy Committee is, I told you, upper limit is 6%, lower limit is 2%. If for any 3 quarters, for at least, if means for the continuously for 9 months, If there is inflation higher than 6% or lower than 2%, what it would mean, that it would mean the failure of the monetary policy committee, that monetary policy was not able to use its instrument and control the inflation. So that would be the failure of monetary policy committee, and government would say that we don't need you for the requirement of the monetary policy. We would make new committee which is going to look after the inflation. Now, six member is bifurcated in three RBI official and three government recommended person. Okay, government has also its say in the monetary policy committee. So this is very important. Can we ask directly the name of the people, that who is the member of the monetary policy committee with four option? So remember these people's name, very, very important. Urjit R. Patel, obviously the governor, he has to be in the monetary policy committee. Then there is Viral V. Acharya, deputy governor of the RBI. And there is Michael Patra. Now, who is Michael Patra? See, he's working for the IMF, International Monetary Fund, and I told you that there is Central Board of Director. The third person in always recommended by the Central Board of Director, Michael Patra, who has been working with the RBI and with the International Monetary Fund from past 25 years, has been recommended by the Central Board of Director that we are putting this person in the Monetary Policy Committee, and he would show our Central Board of Directors' point of view into the Monetary Policy Committee. So remember his name, Michael Patra. He has quite experienced person in the Indian economy. Then there are three government recommended person from the various sectors. The first one is Chetan Ghate, Indian Statistical Institute, which is in the West Bengal. So Chetan Ghate, he has been appointed by the government. Then there is Pammi Dua, the Delhi School of Economics. Now she is the Dean of Delhi School Economics, Pammi Dua. Then third is Ravindra Dhalakia, he is from the faculty. Chetan Ghate is also a professor in ISI, and also Ravindra Dhulakia is faculty in IIM Ahmedabad. So see, these all three are what? These three are not the financial advisor. They are theoretically, so these are professors. So these professors has been sent by the government into the Monetary Policy Committee. Remember their name. If you see, like in June, I am making the video. If you are watching it in the June, August, then there would be a bi-monthly meet. You can see these people's name, that Chetan Ghate was against something resolution, whereas other five was against one, that Pammi Dua and Urjit R. Patel was against, all other were four. So these might come into the news. You might be aware of the name, so it would be easy for you. Then moving on, the government recommended have these four people. See, I told you that Monetary Policy Committee is made for the five years. These three government recommended people have 4 year tenures, which would be later on extended for 1 year, so for the complete 5 year duration. But at the moment, they have 4 year tenures, which is going to end in 2020. Before the constitution of Monetary Policy Committee, which was constituted in 2016, so before that, how the government was, or how the RBI was maintaining the inflation, that was done through the Technical Advisory Committee, which used to advise only RBI, but RBI was the sole member power, has the sole power to when to induce money or when to suck out the money. So that was the power, and these are the monetary policy instruments which I'm going to tell you in the next lecture. This is very important lecture. I would see you that if you are watching this lecture, continue with the next lecture. It's very important, the monetary policy instruments. So after that monetary policy instrument, there would be upcoming topics like functions of RBI, issuer of currency, how it issues currency, lender of last resort, then forex, foreign money, how it keep foreign money, subsidiary of RBI, DIC, GC, BRM, BNPL, National Housing Bank, all these are the subsidiaries, training institutes under the RBI. There are four or five training institute under RBI, so all those. So thank you guys for watching the video. I know the lecture is a little bit of longer, but the thing was, you must understand what is the purpose of the monetary policy. And if you see, it is all about the current scenario. After watching this news, you would be video, you can only understand the current affair news from which question might come directly into your examination. So after watching this video, you can understand the current affairs around the monetary policy. So that was the main purpose. I would suggest to you that also watch out the capital market and money market videos, which has been already uploaded. Watch out the full banking awareness series. Thank you guys. And you can also check out the other playlist section on our channel, which will be very helpful for you. So thank you guys. I, Rohit Thakur, now sign out.